At the center of the showdown, a Maryland man killed in combat overseas and his family, who found themselves facing protesters as they were burying their son. 11 News I-Team reporter David Collins now takes us inside the Supreme Court.
The Supreme Court will decide whether the First Amendment protects funeral protesters from intentionally inflicting emotional distress on the family of the deceased.
On those who claim the title of United States Marines.
Supporters of the Westboro Baptist Church, including children, stood vigil outside the U.S. Supreme Court building, waving signs touting their unwavering beliefs in front of hundreds of people lined up to get inside. The Snyder versus Phelps case may become a landmark decision, creating a new standard for the First Amendment right of free speech and assembly. Back in 2006, members of the Westboro Baptist Church, led by Fred Phelps, staged a protest regarding the U.S. policy on gays in the military. They demonstrated 1,000 feet from the funeral of Marine Lance Corporal Matthew Snyder in Westminster. They chose the site to maximize publicity for their cause and posted video of the event online. But the court of public opinion is clearly not on their side.
I think that what their message is absolutely absurd. It's horrible. It's anti-American.
You have the right for freedom of speech, but there's also a decency line that's been well tread upon.
The question before the high court is whether the First Amendment protects the protesters against civil claims. Matthew's father, Albert Snyder, won a $5 million suit claiming emotional distress against the Westboro Baptist Church, but it was overturned.
There is a civilized way to express an opinion in America, but it does not involve intentionally inflicting emotional distress on others, intentionally harming a private citizen at a private funeral. It's not the constitutional right.
Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg questioned whether the protest singled out Snyder or is a broad comment on the whole rotten society. Antonin Scalia and Stephen Breyer were bothered by the online posting, acknowledging the rules aren't clear. Justice Samuel Alito suggested the posting helped Snyder because it clarified who the pickets targeted. Justice Sotomayor explored the case law regarding a public person applying to a private individual. Justice Kagan inquired about setting a buffer rather than focusing on content. Margie Phelps is the attorney for Westboro Baptist and the daughter of the church founder.
The rule of law is the mere fact that you take offense at words or call yourself having your feelings hurt over words is not enough to shut up the speech.
Reporters asked whether the Phelps family ever considered the Snyder family's feelings.
Crying about your feelings for your sin, no shame. You're going straight to hell on your crazy train.
That's our answer about feelings. Stop worshiping your feelings and start obeying God.
Albert Snyder brought a keepsake of his son with him to court. He declined to say what it was. He wants to keep that private. Mr. Snyder says this isn't a case about free speech. It's about harassment. At the U.S. Supreme Court in Washington, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.
A host of media outlets, including the Associated Press and our parent company, the Hearst Corporation, have signed a brief in support of the First Amendment issues at the center of the debate. If you'd like to read that brief, you can log on to our website, WBALTV.com, and then click on Local News.